have some faces that I don't recognize. I'd really especially like to welcome you. And wondering if we can, we sometimes, or we have had a tradition in the past where we all get up and shake hands, and we don't always do it, but today feels like the right day. So let's get up and welcome each other here and say good morning. With the sunshine outside and a good morning in here, it almost feels like we're done. As a call to worship this morning, I'd like to read the verse in your bulletin as well as a song.
Chapter 28. Matthew chapter 28. Jesus said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I've commanded you. And remember, I am always with you to the ends of the age." Because of Jesus' commandment and promise, we are here today. For this reason, people make this covenant, this commitment of baptism with God and the church. We are witnesses to their choice and we are companions to it. Baptism is an act of God, an act of the church, and of the believer. In baptism, God gives us a good conscience and the seal of the Holy Spirit. Baptism bears witness to what God has done with us, made us dead to sin and alive to Christ. As an act of the church, baptism vouches for the faith of the believer and it affirms the act of grace, the work of grace in their life. And as an act of the individual, baptism enacts their surrender of the old self and their embrace of a new self born in the image of Christ. This time I'm going to invite the candidates to come and share their testimony.
I'm here today to celebrate and to get wet. I originally opted for water balloon, but Mark was suggesting that it wasn't the best idea. I'm also here to announce my understanding, my acknowledgement, that Christ has saved me and granted me entrance into his kingdom beside him forever. We have all had our ups and downs, but my life before moving to Altona had seemed like it had been on a spiraling downhill for far too long. I came to this area a year and a half ago from Winnipeg, from which the house I was living in had tons of mold in it that was creating numerous health problems, mostly for breathing and whatnot, for which the landlord was not willing to do anything about the situation. My best option, move out of there. So I posted on Facebook my problem, and a friend from Altona replied, offering me a place in their home with their family. When you live a life of whatever happens, and an opportunity like this presents itself, I took it as a sign from God. This is a shot for me to turn things around. So I'm very grateful to have such wonderful and loving friends in the area, as it has been a long journey of figuring out who I am where I belong, and where I'm going with my life. After I had met and gotten to know Roxanne, I had asked her for help. Help push me in the right direction. In the direction that I need to go. She had set up a meeting for me to meet with Marco for coffee, which turned into brunch. Although I don't remember everything that we talked about, although a lot of it was, you know, basically how growing up and it made it very easy for me to relate with Marco and to listen to what he had to say. I don't remember much of what he said, but I do remember one thing that stuck. And the one thing that I recall was he said to me, "You might be more Christian than I." I'd like to thank you and everyone that has helped encourage me to stay focused on God, and therefore I am grateful to have met everyone in the Altona and Gretna area, as it has been a huge help for me in my life. I also look forward to waking up every day to see what God has planned for me in my future.
How many of you speak in front of people, but what they just did took a lot of courage. I want to give you thanks for sharing your story with us. After we have baptism, after we get them wet, I'm going to invite you to take some time to show them your enthusiasm in however you wish. Well, you know, keep within reason. So I have a few questions for you. Mike, Whitney, Dave, and Jason. Do you renounce the evil powers of this world and you turn to Jesus Christ as your Savior, putting your trust in His grace, in His love, and promise to obey Him as your Lord? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, in Jesus Christ, God's Son, our Lord, and in the Holy Spirit, the giver of life? Do you accept the Word of God as guide and authority for your life? Are you willing to give and receive counsel in the congregation? Are you ready to participate in the mission of this church? I haven't known you for that long. The first time we met was not too long after you became good friends with Roxanne, and we know her well. She asked me if I would be willing to meet you for coffee, as you mentioned. She said that you had some questions about the Christian faith. Although I may not know you as well as some of the others getting baptized this morning, the times that you and I have shared in conversation have convinced me that the Holy Spirit is at work in your life. Moreover, that Spirit has perked your curiosity about faith. That same Spirit is what draws you here to the water to confess the name of Jesus. Now I ask you a few times this question. After explaining this, what baptism is, that it's the act of renouncing the old life that was locked in sin, that it's turning your life to Jesus. I asked you that a few times, and each time you gave me a very confident and firm answer to that question. It was always, yes, that's what you want. This is what I want, you said. Well, friend, this morning you're going to get wet. Like I'm going to wait to kneel.
Sanctify you completely. May your spirit and your soul and body be kept in until the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. Amen. Mike, Whitney, Dave, and Jason, in the name of Christ and in the name of this church, I give you my hand and I bid you to rise and walk in the newness of life. By the same power that raised Christ from the dead. As long as you continue to abide in his word, you're going to be a disciple of Jesus. You'll be acknowledged as a brother and as a sister in this congregation. You've made the good confession of Jesus Christ, and you've offered yourself to be our companion in journeying with him. May God bless you and make you a blessing in our midst. May the peace of Christ be with all of you. I'm going to invite you to stand. There's a reading that's going to come to you.
Yeah.